Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Pratham and you are watching my channel Pratham R17 YouTube. Today's video is about the Soyuz spacecraft. So without any other further ado, let's get started. Soyuz is a series of spacecraft designed for the Soviet space program by the Korolev Design Bureau, now Energia, in 1960s that remain in service today, having made more than 140 flights. The Soyuz succeeded the Vostok spacecraft and was originally built as part of Soviet crewed lunar programs. The Soyuz spacecraft is launched on a Soyuz rocket from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. After the retirement of the space shuttle in CTS-135 in 2011, the Soyuz served as the only means for Americans to make crewed flights and the only means for Americans to reach the International Space Station until the flight of SpaceX Crew Dragon Demo 2 on May 30th, 2020. The Soyuz is heavily used in the ISS program. The first Soyuz flight was uncrewed and started on 28 November 1966. The first Soyuz mission with a crew, Soyuz 1, launched on 23rd April 1967 but ended with a crash due to a parachute failure killing cosmonaut Vladimir Kramarov. The following flight was uncrewed, Soyuz 3, launched on 26th October 1968, becoming the program's first successful crewed mission. The only other flight that suffered a fatal incident, Soyuz 11, killed its crew of 3 when the cabin depressurized prematurely just before re-entry. These were the only humans to date have died above the Kármán line. Despite these early accidents, Soyuz is widely considered the world's safest, most cost-efficient human space flight vehicle, established by its unparalleled length of operational history. Soyuz spacecrafts were used to carry cosmonauts to and from Salyut and later Mir Soviet space stations, and now used for transportation to and from the International Space Station. At least one Soyuz spacecraft is docked to the International Space Station at all times for uses as an escape spacecraft in an event of emergency. The spacecraft is intended to be replaced by the six-person Orion spacecraft. The orbital and service modules are single-use and are destroyed upon re-entry in the atmosphere. Though this might seem wasteful, it reduces the amount of heat shielding required for re-entry, saving mass compared to designs containing all the living space and life support in a single capsule. This allows smaller rocket to launch the spacecraft or can be used to increase the habitable space available to the crew, which is 6.2 meter cube in Apollo CM versus 7.5 meter cubes in the Soyuz. In the mass budget, the orbital and the entry portions are habitable living space with service module containing the fuel, main engines and instruments. The Soyuz service module is not reusable, it's expendable. The new Soyuz spacecraft must be made for every mission. Soyuz can carry up to 3 crew members and provide life support for about 30% days. The life support systems provide nitrogen oxygen atmosphere at sea level partial pressure. The atmosphere is regenerated through potassium superoxide cylinders, which absorb most of the carbon dioxide and water produced by the crew and regenerated by the oxygen and lithium hydroxide cylinders, which absorb leftover CO2. The vehicle is protected during launch by the payload fairings, which is just descend along with the SAS at 2.5 minutes into launch. It has an automatic docking system. The ship can be operated automatically or by a pilot independently of the ground control. So that's it for today, guys. If you like this kind of space tech videos, please make sure you subscribe to my channel, like this video, 10 likes for a new one, and turn on the notification bell to stay updated. Follow me on Instagram and join my Discord server for further discussion on future topics for my videos. The links will be in the description. So until the next video, stay tuned.